In this video, we're going to talk about something known as PCR. PCR. PCR stands for polymerase chain reaction. So let's look at the process of PCR. And let's start by looking at the history of PCR. PCR basically starts off with some DNA that you're trying to amplify. You're trying to make more copies of the DNA. And you start off with a piece of DNA, it's got two strands, and in order to denature the strands, you apply heat. Now, the problem is that a lot of enzymes that would normally, once you have the two strands separated, a lot of the enzymes that would normally then copy the strands and make double-stranded DNA would denature. They wouldn't work anymore because the heat would basically destroy them. So scientists were able to isolate a bacterial species that actually grows in the geysers in Yellowstone National Park, which is an extremely hot environment. So the bacteria was something known as Thermus aquaticus. And Thermus aquaticus was a species of bacteria that basically had a DNA polymerase, and we call it TAC for Thermus aquaticus polymerase. And this polymerase is able to withstand the high heat needed to denature the DNA strands. So if you apply TAC polymerase to the now denatured single-stranded DNA, it's able to copy, make a complementary copy of the DNA, able to copy it. So basically, this is the overview of PCR. Now let's look at the specifics. So you start off with some DNA, and you apply heat and denature the DNA, so now you've got two strands. What you next need to do is you need to add a primer. So you need to add a little primer. And the primer gives the TAC polymerase a starting point. So the TAC polymerase comes in and basically is able to make the complementary strand. So in order for the TAC polymerase to make the complementary strand, you also need to add in nucleotides. So you need to add nucleotides. And you also needed a primer. So basically, heat acts like helicase, which normally in human DNA would split the double-stranded DNA up into two strands. And the TAC polymerase basically acts like our own DNA polymerase that normally would replicate the DNA. So basically, if you repeat these steps, so you heat, you denature the DNA, then you re-anneal the DNA, allow this elongation process to occur. And if you just keep repeating that, eventually you'll have a whole bunch of copies. So here you start off with one copy of double-stranded DNA. Here you have two copies. If you repeat it, you're going to have four copies and so on and so forth. So you basically get this exponential increase in the copy number of the DNA. And this is really useful in order to create massive amounts of a particular DNA sequence.
So what I want to now talk about is I want to look at the exponential growth that is a hallmark of the PCR reaction. So after we do PCR one time, so we start out with double-stranded DNA, we add heat, it gets denatured, and now we have two strands of double-stranded DNA. So this is one round of PCR. If we do another round, we're basically going to have each one of these denatures, and each one after we add TAC polymerase, and after we add the primer, we're going to have four strands. So this is after round two, we have four strands. And after round three, we're going to have eight. So we go from one, two, four, eight. After round four, we're going to have 16. After five, we're going to have 32, and so on and so forth. And basically, after just a few rounds of PCR, we're able to have thousands and thousands of strands of double-stranded DNA. And that's the power of PCR, is that you get exponential growth. So you start out here and then you really just rapidly get an exponential amount of growth and an exponentially larger amount of DNA that you're interested in.